The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave, you know, and what he gave his only begotten son. That word is strong. He didn't just say his only son, but his only begotten son. It is good for you to know that we are adopted son. God has no other begotten except for Jesus. And let me explain this to you, because people think God could just get a shortcut. There was no shortcut, praise the Lord. He had to give his son for our redemption. The Bible says Jesus is the firstborn from the dead. Why is he saying that? And he had raised Lazarus, he had raised Jairus' daughter. Other people had been raised in the Old Testament. This is what happens. Jesus actually is the only man that has ever died. The rest slept. In fact, he told them, Lazarus' death, he is sleeping and I am glad. That is what he said. But they refused to agree with him. He said, he's sleeping. Jesus is the only person that died in the spirit, body, and soul. He died completely. There has never been a man in hell to date. There's no man in hell. The place that men are preserved before hell is called Hades. The Bible says even Hades will be thrown into hell. But Jesus did not go there pushed by the devil. The Father punished him. It was the Father's punishment on him for us. And he said, for God, he said, loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Today, we have received the anointing to speak the scripture the other way around. So let's try this. Say, for I so loved God that I gave him. Now feel your service to him and your giving to him what is equal to his begotten. Then that was, he said, to be a sacrifice. Praise the Lord. I began to think about something. I was in a mission in December last weekend, and I saw such a massive baptism of the Holy Spirit. That pastor called me a few days to Sunday. You know, it's not easy for any pastor to change his Sunday program. I was to preach in a church. I just told my wife, I hear the Lord saying that I honor this mission. This is a local church in Seme. Then on a Sunday, I did the first service and drove. I was there with my son, Fidel. And you know what? I taught on the Holy Spirit. Amazingly, everyone, including children that came to the altar call, were baptized with the Holy Spirit and spoke in tongues. When we sat out at the compound with Fidel, I asked him with the host pastor, what if I refused to come for this mission? What if I said I'm not going for this mission? Praise the Lord. And on the other hand, as we are driving back, I was driving back, I told Fidel, in such local missions, the money you are given as honorarium is not what you have spent. It is far less than what you have spent. So I my heart was wiped out of doing anything for money in the kingdom of God. Praise the Lord. It's a sacrifice. Last week, I walk every, I wake up very early, prepared. Just a few minutes before 6, I'm on a motorbike to church for morning glory. I have sacrificed my car to take my children to school. I use the motorbike every morning to go for morning glory. And in the prayers, after prayers, For example, on Friday after morning glory prayers, I went to work. I got a transfer from where I used to work. Now I'm here in St. Teresa's, Kibuye. I just crossed from church. That's the advantage, I tell you. I worked the all day up to 7. I left the institution at 7, went to the house. Around 7:30, I was in my house. The next thing is I greeted my children, asked them if they are at home, greeted my wife, passed by the bedroom, began to iron my clothes so that I leave for a Holy Ghost kesha in Moroni. For the first time, my children clung on me and they were crying. I'm always there with them. But I saw the pain and the tears they go through when I have to sacrifice time, their time, to go and do God's work. Yeah. I drove at night to Moroni, preached for 3 hours, up to 3 a.m. Ministered deliverance, baptism of the Holy Spirit. By 3, the 3 gentlemen we went with are not drivers, so I was driving back at night. At some point, they were all asleep in the car. I had to drive with the window open so that I'm not tempted to sleep with that cold. One time I went to El Bagon Secondary School and I drove there all the way to El Bagon. I preached on Friday, preached 3 sessions on Saturday, preached 3 sessions on Sunday. And we finished by 7 at night. I began driving back from El Bagon, coming back to Kisumu. I reached the house and getting out of the car, I was so tired, my feet had some kind of paralysis. So I had to really stretch them so that I may get out of the car. Sacrifice. Give yourself as a sacrifice. Sometimes people can say, pastors are in the front line because they are the vision bearers or they're the ones who are eating the fruit. Sometimes I sympathize with my family. How I have footed, sometimes I've footed church bills from my pocket because money is not enough. There's one time I had money. I had, last year, I got some, is it 90,000 or something? And I was so intended not to tell my wife because she didn't want me to spend that money in church. She wanted me to spend that money in the house. After much negotiation in my heart, I felt the rebuke. We were just from doing IPM Rabu at that time. I drove with her directly to the supermarket and bought her the things she wanted. I said, for the first time, let me just. But you see, as a pastor, I'm doing it with a heavy heart. So may God even deliver us pastors from looking at somebody else's wife more than ours. It's the wife of Jesus Christ, called the church. Let me show you a scripture, then we just finish. The book of Matthew chapter 19, from verse number 17. You see, like the sacrifice of Pastor Judy, you know, I wish she had put the screen there for her. But she just feels I should put it for the church members. Yes. But see how she prioritized that in a service she should never read, but you can come to church pocketing. But life just in gani to lianza nayo. Arajini ansia ya nyuma. There's something in business called opportunity cost. The things we forego. Huh? The things we forego. So that we may give ourselves as a living what? Sacrifice. I said Matthew 19 from 17. Huh? Begin from 16. And behold, one came and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And he said to him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. Okay, by standard, I need to explain this. Jesus was not saying that he's bad. He was just taking cognizance of this man. Okay, you notice that I am God. Because there's no one good except for God. So at least you acknowledge that I am God. Because you said good. But if thou wilt enter, what? It says, Good master, what good thing shall I do to her? Huh? Verse 17. And said unto him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, eternal life or life, keep the commandments. You see, this is so powerful. When Jesus said, When you love me, keep my commandments. Let no one cheat you. Listen to me, people of God. Let no one cheat you that the Ten Commandments are the former laws. Those things are not former. Jesus came to fulfill them. He just broke them into two. He said the first one, love what? The Lord your God with all your heart. And that entails almost number one to number five. He summarized them. Then part two, he said, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Relationship with others. But let no one tell you that, you see, this issue of the Lord needs to be revisited. Praise the Lord. But now he says, it's a sacrifice to keep his commandments. When God speaks to you, do some things that look strange. I tell you, it takes a huge sacrifice to obey God. That word, if you are willing and obedient, everything, you see now, I normally send daily scriptures to our church members. And as I send the scriptures on WhatsApp, I can easily go to Deuteronomy 28 and pick one. You shall be blessed in the city and also in there. And the day I give a prophecy, I receive many feedbacks. Amen. But the day I give an instructions, very few feedback. Praise the Lord. But you see now, even if you are reading maybe 28:12, I will open for you my good treasure, the heavens, and give you rain in his season. You will land and you shall not. Please go also to verses 1 that say, if you diligently obey. Hallelujah. If you diligently is very strong. You are particular about it. Intentional obedience is better than a sacrifice. Obedience is sacrifice, except that it's a higher level than the normal sacrifice we know. Then, of course, there was this conversation, and Jesus said, verse 19, honor thy father and thy mother, and thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. So he summarized the Ten Commandments. Verses 20, the young man said unto him, all these things I have kept from my youth up. What lack I yet? Jesus said to him, if thou wilt be perfect, go and sell that thou hast and give to the poor, and thou shalt do what? Thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. Now, that's the scripture that informed my writing the book called The Treasures of Heaven. Because people think, Reverend, the kind of the place we are going to we have to trust God for remnants, because God is not interested in celebrity pastors. Yeah. And even those who have stepped in the realm of being celebrity, you know their life's span in ministry is very short. Let me tell you the truth. Because I observe, unless you don't want me to observe. The status of ministers, believers in church, are full of words that are powerful, which are good, from great men of God, from Nigeria, worldwide known. You've never quoted your pastor, but you are full of the quotes of the, this. There's nothing wrong with it. I just want to bring a balance here. Bwana Susana, if something happens that a Nigerian preacher gathered thousands somewhere to preach to them, to you that is a revival. That's what? And it can be a great revival. But if you read Acts 19, verse 1 to 7, you notice 12 people. 12 what? Paul just went for 12 people to receive the Holy Spirit. And that was a major revival. Even the house fellowship where Benedict received the Holy Ghost when Reverend Odipo was preaching, that was a revival. You have stopped celebrating salvation that takes place on the altars in your churches on Sunday. You want to celebrate the mega. Ah, unakimbia kwa manyota. Which is not bad, but that will also deny you celebrating yourself, because God has given you so many victories, but because you've set the bar so high, you don't see these ones as victory. Praise the Lord. You win a soul here to the Lord. That's a revival. Praise the Lord. You walk and preach to somebody there. That's a revival. Let me tell you, there's an outbreak of revival in Kenya. Now, it is not on TV. It is not on Facebook. It's not on any other thing. But the last 1 month and 2 weeks, I have seen over 300 baptisms of the Holy Spirit. Yeah. With evidence of praying in tongues. Sustain a level. God builds things in levels. Praise the Lord. Sustain what? A level. People have stopped discipleship because you are waiting for your pastor to disciple. Well, you are the one, as Benedict talked about teachers, you are the one who is become a teacher. He said, older women teach younger women in the church. There's an outbreak of revival in our nation. But you see, if you set your mind that one day God, and God has delivered me, I've delivered. I used to think I would have this mega church. I'm delivered. Listen to me, I don't care. I preach for those who have come to church. Because it's the Lord that brings that. The number of people does not measure the revival. That revival is individual. When a soul is revived. Last Sunday when we were preaching there, I saw, as people were being baptized with the Holy Spirit, one woman could not receive the Holy Spirit. She was just shouting. She could not pray in tongues. And I noticed that's a demon. So I just went and I cast out that demon out. And I said, now receive the Holy Ghost immediately. Tongues. Listen to me. God wants to use you. Actually, let me change it. God is using you. Huh? Tell your neighbor, God is using you. Don't wait until one day you are the guest mega preacher. Huh? Become, invite yourself to a house and preach to them. That's a revival. Revival. That's a revival. I remember some years back, we were in Ondiek Primary, and I have a sister-in-law that needed the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I told her to remain with Dan in church. Dan prayed for her, and she received the Holy Spirit. Was it that I couldn't pray for her? I could. But now I'm saying, it's not an ownership that now it is me. Like I had a pastor call an article for prayer for the sick, and then somebody came praying, say, stop praying. Your prayers have not helped you. Now it's my prayer. If you see, like now, what is happening, leave alone even America. What is going on in high schools now? I tell you, the fire of God is moving in high schools. Great and intense fire. There are young people that God has set. They are just setting them. They are praying for people every day. Salvation, baptism with the Holy Spirit. It does not need to wait for a camp again. Say, God, I am an agent of revival. Let me say this. God will give you the treasure of heaven. The treasure of heaven are spiritual things. They are not material. What? Don't look for. I love today the way things are flowing. Is it Pastor Judy who read Matthew 6? Abel Matthew 6, 33. Yeah? But go back to verses 31 and 32. You see that. Let me use your scripture. I refuse to sacrifice for you. Let's see together. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear? 32. For after all these things, the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. Now, before you go to the other one, He knows. Please stop praying for God to give you a house, for God to give you a Prado. Yeah. Focus on His agenda. He's called souls. Focus in His sacrifice yourself to serve Him. He knows. Now the body of Christ is being waylaid into pursuing material things, so that my people begin to measure me in terms of what I own. It's wrong. It's error, actually. It's not doctrinally right. Praise the Lord. People look at if someone builds a mega building, how many of them now in Europe are supermarkets? And they were building the peak of revivals. God's agenda is people. Hallelujah. The intention of God is a revival on people. Then now, if we stop following what the Gentiles follow, we will love God and we give Him our time. In other words, somebody will say, the Gentiles are in Kibuye now, looking for what? Money. So somebody say, I will also not go for prayer because I'm going to pursue money. There's a need of sacrifice to come back in the house of God. Let there be a revival of sacrifice in the house of God in the name of Jesus. If you're going to go any level as church, it's going to take sacrifice. The men of God that people criticize all over, of course, doctrinally, we might not agree, but the power of God is moving. But how much have they invested in terms of people who are just there praying? Yeah. And where people labor to pray for hours, God will move. Yes. Hallelujah. God will do what? Will move. But if your mind is mixed up on what the world is looking for, yeah, when the world is, in fact, the world have them more than the people in the church who are looking for them. I refuse to give testimony of material things. I refuse to give testimony of material things. When you follow my social media, I am full of testimonies of what God is doing in the lives of people. Salvation, baptism of the Holy Spirit. What is it if I build a house? How many people have houses? Some of them are pride, actually. Generated pride. Praise the Lord. Mungu atusaidie, turudikwa the place. Then it says, now seek ye first the kingdom. It's a sacrifice. It's a sacrifice to live luxuries that people are looking for. And then you say, I am seeking the kingdom first. It's my priority to seek the kingdom. Hallelujah. How do we live as believers? Our worship day is on Sunday. I see we have an entire row of SDA shops near our place. On a Saturday, they are all closed. By 6 in the evening, they are all closed. I come from a polygamous family. One of my nephews, the child died. And in that house of my mother, elder mother, they got to SDA. The body was to travel. You know, the child died on Friday, somewhere on Friday. They say the child's body cannot be removed from Kenyatta on the Sabbath. They have to wait until after six to remove the body so that the body can travel at night on Saturday, the burial on Sunday. So some of us could not attend the burial because we also asked them, what of our Sabbath? Yeah. So what if I stopped going to Seme for that church for over 30, 40 people to be baptized with the Holy Ghost to go for our burial? Huh? Can you say sacrifice? There's a level of, but let me show you something. Verses 22, we'll go back to Matthew 19. But when the young man heard that saying, he went away sorrowful, and he had great possessions. How many of you have been sorrowful because you came to church and pastor wanted money for tithes? You left the church sorrowful because you felt pastor wanted your money. Hallelujah. But verse 23 say, then said Jesus unto his disciples. Of course, the story, you know, the camel. Huh? Verses 25. When his disciples heard it, he said, it's difficult for a rich man to get to the kingdom. But when they heard this, what did they say? They were exceedingly amazed, saying, who then can be saved? But Jesus, verses 26, beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. Then answered Peter. I love Peter. Kila congregation lazima kuwe na kiere. Kierere kama Peter. Peter said unto him, behold, master, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have thereof? A very right question. But I underlined that. He said, we have left everything. Peter said, we have left everything to follow you. Following Jesus, there's a cause. He said, do what? Take you up. Deny yourself then. Take your cross and follow me. It's a sacrifice to follow the Lord. You have to come to a place where you are called a fool for serving God. For following God. To be called a fool. When you obey God, they can call you a fool. It's permitted. Huh? Because God has also chosen the foolish things of this world. Huh? To disapprove what? The wise. He has chosen the foolish things of this world. Faith sometimes demands that you don't agree with the nature. Ah, because God speaks contrary to the expectation of many. Hallelujah. We have left all. But Jesus wanted to teach them a lesson that as you leave all, don't set your mind on what you'll get, Peter. It's the matter is not what you will get. Huh? And verses 26, 20 what? 28. And Jesus answered and said to them, listen to this. Verily I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the generation when the Son of Man shall sit in the throne of his glory, you also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. What a privilege. And everyone that forsake, huh? Forsaken what? House, brethren, sisters, fathers, mothers, wife, or children, or land, for my name's sake, shall receive an hundredfold and shall inherit everlasting life. There's a reward for serving God. Hallelujah. God is not a user. God is a rewarder. But he does not want you to be a worshiper of rewards. He wants you to be his worshiper. God is a jealous God. He wants your heart to be fixed in worshiping him sacrificially. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. That word was heavy in my heart. I wanted to bring it forth. And because you are prayed, we just want to declare you're blessed. Hallelujah. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Declare you're blessed. Lift your hands and just say, I am blessed. Pray for yourself. You've been praying for issues. Now pray for yourself. Declare the grace of God upon your life. Lord, grace me to be sacrificial, that I'll be able to give myself as a living sacrifice. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Rabo Sekema Gadaya. Come on, open your mouth and declare, I am sacrificial in everything that I do. I give myself, oh, to the altar of God. I give myself as an altar to the altar of God, to be used of God, not for profit, Lord, but for the advancement of the kingdom. Let every other thing find me. Let every other thing follow me. Oh, Sharabi Kanaya, Via Sole Prakataya. We find a repentance in our heart, Lord. Anytime we are prioritized pursuit of material things, the things that the Gentiles are looking for, Lord, we repent. We come back to you, Lord. We come back to the heart of worship. Heart of worship, and we shall worship you from the depths of our hearts. Lepe Sarabakaya. Jesus, you are my owner. Till the day that you come, let you be the idol in my heart. Bila sore bekama taya biantaya. Become the object of my faith. I repent, Lord, of any attachment with these strange gods, with things that do not add value to the kingdom of God. Mercy, Lord. Rakabo setembra nadia. We are coming, Lord, to the place of sacrifice. We give ourselves, Lord, to you. Oh, as a living sacrifice. La temperano se chaos. He's a sacrifice. Oh, the world have known how to sacrifice to their altars and their gods. They have cut themselves to shed blood for their gods. Our sacrifice is not for harm. Our sacrifice is diligent obedience to our God and being available in his service. Lord, today we make a bow down. We repent and we come back to you, our God. Any man no set up rekedi bi la de posarin kainto maya lembrate malabia zaya. We are stepping, Lord, out sacrificially in the service of the kingdom of God. Any barrier that the enemy would want to use to hinder our sacrifice, we cut it off in the name of Jesus. We rebuke the hand and intention of Sanballat and Tobiah spirit that would want to poison and corrupt our hearts away from your service. We will not be silent. We will not be discouraged from your service, oh God. Yes, Sapora Nibakaya, by Los Tebradikana, Enepadi Balano Setaya. We will not be silent, Lord. We will serve you sacrificially. We let go, my Father, of any intention of anything, Lord, that does not give you glory. And we come, Lord, to the platform of sacrifice to diligently be obedient to your word. Lift your voice and cry out to God for mercy. Shalom Okonaya. Alababo Sedebaya. La Kapakato Sibianaba. Tunafua mapambo yetu Bwana na vitu vyote vya thamani kwetu, mioyo yetu twaleta mbele zako Bwana, tunaileta mioyo yetu mbele zako. Utusamehe Bwana, uturehemu, tuwe kama sarapaya lepra kapakataya. Tunajitoa kama sadaka mbele yako Bwana, tukutumikie kwa ukuu na nguvu. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, our God. Thank you, Lord, for the honor and the privilege to serve you. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. Will be sacrificial, Lord, in Jesus' name. The barriers that the enemy is using to fight the church in Kisumu needs a lot of sacrifice. And maybe this is not going to come from so many people, but the remnants, those that are saying we shall break the back of the enemy out of our city. You know, when Elijah, when he said, I'm the only prophet of Baal, God said there are 70 more who have not defiled themselves. May you be among the number. Among the prophets that have not defiled themselves. When they say, someone can stand and say, I am the only revivalist in the nation. Oh, there are 70 more. May you become that hidden revivalist that is doing door to door and bringing salvation, baptism of the Holy Spirit in unknown places. You don't want to be on the media. Leave these things that are being done because of media and fame and publicity. They are good for advancing the kingdom. But listen, the intention might be complicated. Ha! May you be that person that will be driven into the villages where you stir up revivals in places where there are no media like Philip. Yes. And taking the fire of God in every corner of those places to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Oh, rise to make him alive. Worship you, King of Kings. We give you the praise, Lord. We will not be silent. We'll always worship you. Don't look for higher stages. Just serve God in the stage where you are. And God will lift you. If you lift yourself, you will fall down. Someone say, when you jump up, you must come down. But when you grow up, you'll remain up there. Let God grow you. Where you are, serve God fully. Don't come to serve God in that department and your eyes is in something else that is still coming many years. Focus and do it as unto the Lord. As he say, him that can be trusted with little can also be trusted with much. When God sees your faithfulness, he will also lift you to another level. In Jesus' name. Put your hands together and celebrate Jesus. Amen.